Let's just talk about books. If I have this piece of hair that's not leaving me alone. Don't mind that. I mean, Murder, Death, Grief, and Sorrow, or The Perfect Lie. It's like a piece of art. What my version of heaven will be like. This is probably one of my most exciting books in this haul. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today we are doing another book haul. I have been doing a lot of these on my channel lately. I have a pretty decent stack here, so I'm going to be sharing all of these with you guys. Like I say in all my, I have this piece of hair that's not leaving me alone. Like I say in all my book hauls, I don't always read what my books are about. Sometimes I just pick them based on reviews or like word of mouth, or sometimes honestly like just the cover. So I don't always know what they're about. So I will tell you if and what I know about these books, if I know anything. And of course I will have all of them linked down below per usual. And definitely make sure y'all share with me what book you're reading, or like what books you're into, or what you have on your want to read list, or let's just talk about books in the comments. I feel like that is so much fun. I just love talking books with people. I have a lot of friends that are like bookworms and book nerds like me, and I just love chit-chatting about books. So let's do that in the comments, and without further ado, let me show you these books I got. So these first couple books are some used books, and then the rest are all brand new. So I kind of have a mixed bunch over here, but the first one here is All the Ugly and Wonderful Things by Brynn Greenwood. And even like the back of this, it doesn't really say much. It just says it's a beautiful and provocative love story between two unlikely people and the hard-won relationship that elevates them above the Midwestern meth lab backdrop of their lives. This book challenges all we know and believe about the human heart. Like, it's very vague, so I don't mind reading the back of this book because it doesn't actually tell me pretty much anything about what this is about. And I just think the cover is also just so pretty, and this is actually a pretty fat book. This has over 400 pages, and it also has a little reading group like question and answer kind of thing in the back of the book, which is always cool. I love paperbacks, by the way. That is like my preferred style of book or type of book. I'm really excited. I have heard such good things about this book, and I've had it on my want to read list for a while, so I'm really excited, and I'm gonna say that about every book, so don't mind that. So this is called Sometimes I Lie by Alice Feeney, and this just sounded really interesting. Like, literally all it says on the back here at the very top is, my name is Amber Reynolds and there are three things you should know about me. I'm in a coma, my husband doesn't love me anymore, and sometimes I lie. It's like literally listed like 1, 2, 3, and I don't know what about that made me so intrigued by this book, but it just sounded so different and so interesting, and like such a completely different like plot than any other book I've read before. And that is what I'm really drawn to. There's another book in here that is kind of similar to that. Like, when I hear of a plot line that just sounds so interesting, like I want to know what is going on and how this scenario unfolds, those are the kind of books that I'm just like, oh my gosh, I cannot wait to read that. So this was that for me. But like I was saying, some of these are used, this is one of those. And the funny thing about buying used books is sometimes you don't know what you're gonna get, and I didn't realize this was the large print edition. So like, I mean, the print's pretty, it's pretty big, which I mean, it isn't gonna bother me, hopefully. It just is really big. I'm probably gonna feel like I'm reading this so fast because I'm gonna read a page in like 2 seconds, but I did not realize that at the time, but it's totally fine. I also thought it was kind of interesting because it's like a hardcover, but it doesn't have like a sleeve on it. It's like a hardcover with the cover design already on it, which I feel like is very rare. I think I only have one other book like that. I feel like a lot of books don't come that way. So I'm really excited. This just sounds so interesting and just looks so different. This next one I have here is called The Light Between Oceans by ML Steadman. And this definitely has something to do with like a lighthouse. And I think it's about this man and wife that are like, kind of not like stranded in the lighthouse, but they live there and they have a daughter, and it's for like a couple years, and then I guess when they're done with like their term of running the lighthouse, they try to like go back into society and something like that. Like, they have a hard time assimilating back into society or something along those lines. I don't know if someone like dies or like if there's additional drama, but I don't want to reread the back again because it's actually pretty long, and like I said, I don't like to know everything about the book, but I think that's like the general concept. But I remember reading it and just being like really intrigued by the concept, and I also just thought it was so beautiful, like the font and the different colors. I just feel like the cover seems like it's glowing. It's like a piece of art, and again, it's a paperback, which I just love. I feel like this is going to be a really interesting book and kind of different. If y'all don't know, I typically lean towards like mystery novels, murder, suspense, or thriller books, but I have also been trying to like branch out a little bit, so books like this are kind of that for me. So this next book is called Behind Closed Doors by B.A. Paris. This is like such an oddly shaped book. I feel like it's really like skinny and tall, and like I feel like just not your normal book shape. This is also a used book, however this does not look used or read or touched like barely at all. This book sounds so interesting. From what I remember, it's basically about this couple that like kind of appears to have this perfect life, and they're like beautiful and they're wealthy and they just like are living like the high life, but there's just some weird things about the wife that you can never get her in contact with her without like going through her husband, and she doesn't ever seem to go anywhere by herself, and like people just start noticing these weird things about their relationship, although it appears perfect, it's like not. And so it's basically about what is going on like with couples behind closed doors, and things that can like appear really perfect are usually really not. So it seems like it might kind of be like, I don't know if it's domestic violence or just like a control thing or what it's about, but I'm obviously married, so I kind of find books about marriage interesting. Obviously these are not like normal marriages, but it does seem like it's gonna be interesting. It says the perfect marriage ? Or the perfect lie. So it just sounded interesting. This is definitely not red. Like when I'm opening it, like it doesn't even feel like it's ever been like held open. It says that this is an instant New York Times and USA Today bestseller and international phenomenon. So it's gotta be good. So this next book I actually think is the only book from Barnes & Noble in this haul, which typically I go to Barnes & Noble like every couple days, just check out what they have new going on. But I haven't found anything that's really intrigued me the last couple times I went, but I did find this one. This was in the book annex section, so they're like a little bit discounted. And this is called The Sun Does Shine, How I Found Life and Freedom on Death Row by Anthony Ray Hinton. So this is totally not the kind of book I would typically reach for, but it was in Oprah's book club, which typically means, just like with Reese Witherspoon, I feel like I trust the books in those lists because they're usually pretty good or like profound or just popular or just well written. This, as you can kind of tell, is about an inmate on death row who is wrongfully accused. Like, he's innocent, but he spent a lot of time on death row. I think he gets off. I'm assuming he gets off. That's how he wrote a book. Obviously he doesn't die. I'm pretty sure it gets all worked out and he like clears his name, but this is kind of, I think it's kind of like a memoir. It's a powerful, revealing story of hope, love, and justice and the gift of reading by a man who spent 30 years on death row for a crime he didn't commit. And so I love that it's about reading. I think that's interesting. I'm really just interested in the whole concept of it. I feel like this is the kind of like movie or like documentary I'd be interested in. It just seems like it's different. I'm interested to see what the crime is that he was accused of and like how he got accused of it wrongly. And I don't know if they found the right person and how they cleared his name and got him off. So I just feel like this will be different and really interesting. And again, like I said, I'm kind of trying to like switch up the types of book I read, so I'm not just constantly reading about murder, death, grief, and sorrow, you know? I feel like it's good to kind of expand your horizons when it comes to reading. These next three books are all from my book of the month order. I can never just get one. I always end up purchasing a couple because I can never decide. This one I'm really excited about. I was kind of back and forth on this one, but it did get pretty good reviews. For some reason, I'm just really intrigued by the storyline. It's called The Girl in the Mirror by Rose Carlisle. And then right here it says, twin sisters, identical on the outside, dangerously different on the inside. And from what I remember, it's about obviously identical twins, and one of them is getting married, I believe. But I also think their father dies, or the person that they're marrying's father dies, so like there's this big inheritance kind of up for grabs. So one of them kills her identical sister and kind of like assumes her life to get the inheritance, like something along those lines. I'm not 100% sure. I love book of the month books though. Look how pretty the cover is. It kind of goes all the way from front to back. They're just such nice books, really nice quality. I do wish that they had the option to get paperback or hardcover, because they are always a hardcover and I really wish that I had another option. So this is kind of more along the lines of what I've been telling you guys, like the thriller, murder kind of mystery. It sounds really, really good, and it did have really good reviews. This next one is called A Pretty Little Wife by Darby Kane. It says there's more than one way to end a marriage. I actually have a discount code that gets you a brand new book for, sometimes it's $4.99 and sometimes it's $9.99. It totally varies based on like what their promotion is, but either way, it gets you a book for like cheaper than you can get it on Amazon or basically anywhere. It's under 10 bucks for sure, possibly under $5. It's an insane deal no matter how you slice it. It's such a good deal because y'all know books can easily be, you know, $15, $16, $20. I will have that link down below. Book of the Month is like one of my favorite things to get every month. And this book is huge. I did not realize. This is like just about 400 pages. It's a little bit thick, at least compared to this book. This book seems like it's just like small. I think it's about a wife that kills her husband and then like can't find his body. So there's somebody else also kind of participating in making him disappear, but like she doesn't know who. So she killed him, but someone else like got rid of his body and she doesn't know where it is. And so it seems like, again, one of those storylines, it's just like, that's a crazy concept. What actually happens? Like, I just need to know how that plays out. So this looks really, really interesting. I'm super excited to give this one a read. And then one of the most exciting books in this whole entire haul, I feel like this book, it has just been like extremely hyped up and it's actually really expensive. I think the supply and demand is there. It's kind of hard to get your hands on, but I got it because Book of the Month is the best. And it's called The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue by V.E. Schwab. I'm sure you guys have heard about this. I don't even think I probably need to talk much about it. It just is in the back. back, a life no one will remember, a story no one will ever forget. And it's about a woman who kind of not like sells her soul to the devil, I don't think, but kind of sells her soul in exchange for I'm not sure what, but she's plagued with never being able to be remembered. But I think she can live forever. So she like basically goes about her life meaning nothing to anybody because no one can remember her. But then I think she's 600 years old, not actually, but like really, really old. And she like runs into somebody that like knows her name. And so it's just this like a big, huge thing about, I guess, how that person remembered her, or is the curse, or you know, whatever, wearing off. It just sounded, again, super interesting. Like the concept of someone who will never be remembered. Like, what is the purpose of your life? And how do you go about a life knowing that nobody can or will remember you, and how you navigate that, and kind of like the psychological and mental component. Like, it just sounds, again, like such an interesting plot. I need to know how it goes down. So I cannot wait to read this. I don't know what the deals with this book. I've seen it listed on Mercury for like $100, $75. I don't know if they're signed or like if there's special editions or something of this book, but it seems like this book is just all the rage right now. So if everyone's obsessed with it, then I assume I will probably love it. It's also just really kind of pretty the way it's put together. It's actually got really, really tiny font. I'm not sure if y'all can tell. The font's really small. This is probably one of my most exciting books in this haul. And then last but not least, I went to Books A Million, which that place, I swear, is what my version of heaven will be like. I'm pretty sure it is a massive. They always have literally every book under the sun that you could possibly imagine. They have a huge section of like the discounted books, which is always where I start. Their like clearance or like bargain book section is literally 20 times the size of Barnes & Noble. It is huge. So the first one I grabbed was Modern Lovers by Emma Straub. I also have, I believe, the other book by Emma Straub. I think it's called All Adults Here. And I haven't read that one yet, but I've heard just amazing things about her. And I've heard that this book is really good as well. And hello, it was $3.97, which is insane. Plus, I had a coupon on top of it. I am so excited. This has really small font as well, but it is paperback, which I like about that store as well. They usually have the hardcover and the paperback version, always for the same price generally. So I love that I have the option to choose the paperback or the hardcover. So I could not believe I found this. This book I actually almost chose as one of my add-ons in my book of the month this order, but I'm glad that I didn't, because I got this for probably like $6.50 or something like that. I could not believe, again, that they have books that book of the month halves, because those are usually top sellers and fairly new. And I can't believe that a book that was on there was also in the bargain book section. I was so excited to grab this. She is a New York Times bestselling author. This is something about like a firefighter, and that's kind of all I remember about it. I know that it's got really, really amazing reviews, and I also just think the cover is really pretty. I just like the aesthetic of it. Oh, and it has a review by Jodi Picoult on it. Jodi Picoult is my favorite author of all time ever. If she speaks highly about a book, then I know I'm going to love it as well. This next book I wasn't 100% sure about. I know that Elin Hildebrandt is really good. I have quite a few of her books, and I know that she's like one of the most prolific authors out there. I feel like she has like 5,000 books, and this is technically part of a series, and I typically don't pick up books that are part of a series. Even if you can read them without reading the series, I typically just don't like to dive into the middle of one. I don't know, out of principle or something. But this is the first one in the series, so I figured this one was worth trying. Again, this was like under $3 after my coupon. I'm actually excited about the storyline though. It has something to do with her husband dying, and she goes to the island, I guess, where he died on like a business trip, and realize he's living like a totally separate life. I think he has like a girlfriend or just a whole nother life going on, and she kind of has to like pick up the pieces and get his affairs in order, and she had like no idea what was going on. So I thought it sounded kind of interesting. I loved the artwork on it as well. I just think it's a beautiful like looking book. I'm excited about this one. Maybe I'll get into the series afterwards. This book, it's so funny. I literally had to text my husband while I was at the store, and I was like, can you see if I have this book? Because I think it reminds me a lot of The Anonymous Girl, or An Anonymous Girl, which I'm staring at my bookshelf right now. And it's, I just realized it's because they're by the same exact author. You know how some authors will do kind of like a theme, and all their books have like a similar theme to the cover, like a similar photo, the same font, sometimes like the same colors. Like, these look identical. But also, this has been on my want to read list for a really long time. It sounds so interesting. Listen to the back of this. When you read this book, you will make many assumptions. You will assume you are reading about a jealous ex-wife. You will assume she's obsessed with her replacement, a beautiful younger woman who is about to marry the man they both love. You will assume you know the anatomy of this tangled love triangle. Assume nothing. So again, that just like kind of sucked me in, and I want to know more. And the odd thing about both of these is they both have two authors. It's Greer Hendrickson and Sarah, can't see the name of either of them because of the sticker. I feel like it's unusual to have a book with multiple authors. I don't really see that very often, but I'm so excited I finally got my hands on this. And that's the thing about going to some of these bookstores, like I don't just find random books that just kind of look interesting and I pick them up. All the books I buy are always books that I've had had on my want to read list that I've heard about, that I know about. I typically never just buy something random. It's very rare that I do that. It's typically fairly targeted. So the fact that I could find books that I've been specifically wanting to read for such a great deal is always so exciting. But the most exciting book of this whole entire haul, I cannot believe I found this. This is Everything by Jennifer Weiner. I had a friend actually tell me that this book by her is either just as good or better. She just said this was an amazing book as well. And I love the cover of it. I feel like the colors are just beautiful. And like you can see, she is a New York Times bestselling author. I don't know anything about this book really. I haven't read anything about it, but I got it as a recommendation from someone that I like trust their opinion. So I know I'll like it. And I know that she's just a really popular author, especially right now. So I feel like I can trust what she writes. That was probably my biggest win of that trip. I could not believe I found that. I think there was only that and like one other copy. So I feel like people were definitely snatching those up. Alrighty guys, so that is actually all the books for this video. Like I said, I will link them all down below along with the link for book of the month so you guys can get a really good deal. And even if you just want to get the one book and then cancel, you can totally do that. Get a brand new book for a really good price and then never get it again. That's totally something that you can do as well. So I will link all of that down below for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed. If you would like to subscribe, we would love to have you. We have so much fun here. And until next time, I will see you guys in our next video. Bye guys. I run away.